Okay, so before we proceed, I want to fill in these numbers again and rerun this program to get values that correspond to what you'll see on the Udacity IDE. Until now, as I've mentioned, I've been using my laptop, but we're going to let you play around with this transpose code, and I want you to see on the screen numbers that are a little bit more comparable to what you'll get on the much bigger GPUs that Udacity is using versus the one that's in my laptop. Okay, so here's the code we've looked at before. This time it's running in the Udacity IDE. And what I want to do now is do a test run. And here's the results we get. So you can see that now transpose serial took 82.6 milliseconds all the way down to transpose parallel per element tiled, which took about 0.13 milliseconds. So here I've written those results down again. And now we can go through and fill in the DRAM utilization. So you can see that we've got the same pattern. The serial version of the code, which runs in a single thread, takes 82.7 milliseconds. As we get more parallel, we start moving into single milliseconds and then sub-millisecond. And by the time we get here, we're running quite well at 0.35 milliseconds. And sure enough, by tiling that code, we improve on this a little bit, but now we're still spending a lot of time waiting at barriers. And by going to a smaller tile size, we can get that all the way down to 0.13 milliseconds. And at this point, we're getting about 43.5% of the theoretical peak limit of our bandwidth, and that's actually doing pretty good. There's one last optimization effect that we're not going to talk about at this lecture, but you're welcome, in fact encouraged, to go look it up in the CUDA C best practices guide or on many presentations that you can find online if you're motivated and curious. I decided that it's a fairly subtle effect and not too important, and that's shared memory bank conflicts. Essentially, what this says is that shared memory is organized into banks, and depending on how you line up your thread accesses that the array of threads is making to the memory that's actually stored in the tile, you can end up spending a lot of time sort of replaying over and over. You saw that shared memory replays statistic much earlier when we were looking at the NVVP output, and that's what this is about. The fix is relatively simple. And as I said, we're not going to go into it here, but there's a version of this code that you can download and play with on the wiki. The fix is actually simply to reserve a slightly larger chunk of shared memory than you're actually going to use. And this has the effect of padding the shared memory and striping it across the banks, which can actually improve our runtime even slightly more.